I agree with Mayor Gahana's point that the decision on the lands and on expulsion was made by the Jews of Israel. What is the statement of the Jews of Israel? 99% of the electorate voted against your position. Not a stubborn Arabs. The United States, a party that gets 1%, puts you behind Lyndon LaRouche and the Socialist Labor Party of the Leon. The only reason that you have a seat in the Knesset is because Israel has a democracy to a fault. It gives, in proportional representation to 1%, which in America would be considered a limited fringe. So the fact that really we're dealing with here is that the very democracy that you mock is what gives you the chance to speak altogether. But the overwhelming consensus of democracy, the overwhelming consensus of democracy is to show respect and to show mutual concern and to look for a peace. Now, there is no Arab ruler willing to say at the present time they will settle the territorial compromise on the West Bank. Then, of course, if they do not step forward, they will get nothing. We are not speaking here of naivete or foolishness. But we are speaking, the question is there a chance for peace? Or do we, in fact, live in indefinite and permanent war? The answer is, if the Arabs become realistic, if they're prepared to live and let live, I repeat that, then they have a chance to get something on the West Bank. That is the international feeling, that is the response now shown here, and of Paris, it is the response of any Jew who has both respect for humanity and concern for Jewish faith and Jewish future. We want to build a state that's Or LaGoyim, not to sit and fight murderously for the sake of Mayor Gahana's fantasies of expelling the Arabs. And as for the Arabs who come from Ashkelon or Be'er Sheva, my answer is the Oriental Sephardic Jews settled down in their new country, built a new life. It's one of the greatest achievements of human dignity. The Ethiopian Jews came in, they're building a new life. And the Arab refugees and the Arabs who have left the original boundaries of Israel or any other part of it have a chance to settle too. And once the atmosphere clears up and there is peace, that is the way it will end up. And I notice that you have still not responded to the demographic question. You try to throw in side comments like flowing back, but the Israel statistics, the government statistics show that the net outflow of Arab continues down to this year. So I quote Rabbi Soloveitchik from Yehuda Amital and Rabbi Avadi Yosef, simply, life before land. The highest holiness in Judaism is not land, but lives. And therefore, pikuach nefesh in this case is a valid basis for establishing peace. I really hope that we can get through this debate without descending into a position of the demagogue. 99% voted against Gahana. We're dealing with an issue here, giving up land. 99% voted to give up land. The Likud is against giving up land. Chiyah is against giving up land. Kahana is against giving up land. Most of the Mabal is opposed to giving up land. That, my friend, makes a majority of the Knesset against giving up land. Secondly, wait till this next election. The question of giving up land in terms of halacha, there are rabbis for, the rabbis against, as with everything else, as with everything else. The two chief rabbis of Israel are opposed to giving up land. Lubavitcher Rebbe is opposed to giving up land. The Ger Rebbe is opposed to giving up land. Rav Soloveitchik is for it. Upon the base of pikuach nefesh, that a danger to life means giving land. I put it to you that if we gave up land, the danger to life would be a thousandfold greater. And weep for the Palestinians. You say that they also want their homeland? Fine. I'm with you. Anytime they want to go to Jordan and call it Palestine, I will ask. Jordan is made up today of 75% Palestinians. Jordan? Since when is Jordan a legal state? The League of Nations in 1919 created a mandate for the British.
finished to create a Jewish state on both sides of the Jordan. They're finished by fiat, cut away the Eastern Bank in 1942 and gave it to the grandfather of this oppressed in Egypt. And called it Transjordan. That's a legal state. Who recognized it? Nobody did. And to this day, I still don't. And anytime Arafat would like to sit down with Kahana, I'll help him create a Palestine in Jordan, but not one Israel.